Today's title sequence was inspired by the new show 24 Legacy. The actual intro features similar erratic flashes of light on the title and the text. This effect is possible in HitFilm Express to a degree, but you might miss out on some of the extra details, like anamorphic light flares or TV damage. You can download this template for free from the preset marketplace. I'm Javier Valbar for inScapeDigital.com. Let's get started. We'll begin by creating a new text layer and making it 1920 pixels wide. I'll type the word legacy, then a subtitle for the date and channel. Let's highlight the title and come over to the text panel. I'll center it, then select the top word. For this, I use the Bank Gothic MD font and set the size to 200. For the subtitle, I used Avenir Next, which you can download from defont.com. The flashes of light are made using a combination of fractal noise layers and glow effects. The purpose of the first fractal noise that I'm adding here is to add dark spots on the text, so that it's not uniformly white. First, I'll keyframe the seed, skip to the end, and set it to around 5. This will give it a bit of movement. I'll decrease the scale under transform just a little bit to 80. Down in the subsettings, decrease the influence to 0. The spots will look more like blobs and won't have much noise. Now come down to appearance, color 1, and make it dark blue, almost black. Let's add the first glow effect. I'll set the blending mode to add and keep all three of these attributes low. In the per channel intensity controls, make it a deep blue color. The next fractal noise effect will generate the orange flashes. Once again, I'll keyframe the seed and increase the scale to 400. Lower the influence to around 20% and then come down to color 2. Set this to be bright orange. Raise the exposure all the way up. Set the blending mode to add, then lower the offset until it starts to break up. You can set this to be higher or lower, depending on how much of your text you want to be orange. Now I'll make a blue fractal layer using the same technique. Duplicate the orange effect and rename it. Then just change the color and seed values so that it's not exactly the same. I added two small glow effects, with the blending mode set to screen. This was to kind of diffuse and soften the light a little bit. Next up is the Scanlines effect. Set the frequency to 275, sharpness to 1.7, and angle to 90. Change the offset to negative 0.05. Now add a three-tier glow effect, with the radius low, medium, and high. The blending mode for these was set to add. You can alternate adjusting the per channel intensity to orange or blue to further colorize the text. Once you get the glows looking good, add an anamorphic lens flare effect. Come down to streak and set the alignment to center. Uncheck vertical pivot, then decrease the length until it's almost right on top. Lower the blur and intensity until it's barely visible. This is to give the text a ghosting effect. This next part was done using the Neon Path effect in HitFilm Pro 2017, but I found a workaround for earlier versions that I'll show you now. Duplicate your text layer, rename it, and delete all of the effects. I'll go ahead and hide the original just so that we can see it. Highlight the text, then in the text panel, click this transparent button to get rid of the color. Now in the outline box, type in 3 to see it. If you change the original title, you'll have to update the outline text as well. Let's add a grade layer. First thing I'll drop on there is another anamorphic lens flare. This one I made horizontal and decreased the intensity. The thing about glows and light is that they can stack up pretty quickly, so keeping things subtle will prevent your title from looking blown out or getting a weird color. Next up was Bleach Bypass. I set the amount to 60% and the brightness to 45. I don't think I've used the TV damage effect in any of my tutorials so far, but I decided to try it out. This effect includes many in one, with some turned off or on by default. I went through and unchecked Enable on all of them, and then turned on the ones I needed. I started with ghosting, and keyframed the number to quickly move up and down over a couple of frames. This made it look like the text was glitching out. If you want this to happen multiple times, just copy and paste those three keyframes. The other effect I enabled was electrical interference. Under placement, I raised the area width so that it was covering more of the screen. I then decreased the width so that it wasn't as visible. I keyframed the quantity to start out large, but decrease over a few seconds. The sound design was from Video Copilot's Motion Pulse. Don't forget to download this template from the preset marketplace and try it out yourself. Let me know if you have any questions below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video.